What did you have for breakfast? What's your mum's name? How do you turn on your computer? If you could answer any of these questions, you were using your memory. Whilst this might seem like a daft question to ask, what is memory? The American Psychological Association's Dictionary of Psychology defines memory in three ways. The ability to retain information or representation of past experience, specific information or specific past experience that is recalled, and the hypothesized part of the brain where traces of information and past experience are stored. Critically, memory is a hypothetical construct, and therefore everything you'll learn about memory is theoretical, which, when it comes to debating, can be a lot of fun. Cognitive psychologists generally agree that there are three processes of memory. One, registration. This refers to the point that something enters the memory system. Two, storage, referring to where the information waits before. Three, retrieval, the process of recalling the information. Now, it's important to remember that not all psychologists are cognitive psychologists, but for now we'll focus on a cognitive model of memory called the two-process model. The model was first published by Atkinson and Shiffrin in 1968 and features the fairly familiar constructs of short and long-term memory. We experience a stimulus via sensory memory, a memory store that takes in as much as is possible at every single moment of the day. Think about your five senses. You never turn them on and off, but you aren't always aware of them. This is because only the relevant information is passed from sensory memory to short-term memory. If you're escaping from a burning building, you don't need to know what your taste buds can sense, but your sense of touch, informing you of the temperature, will be prioritized. Equally, when you're eating a bowl of chicken soup, your sense of taste will be particularly important, but your sense of touch, making you aware of which parts of your body are in contact with your chair, is less relevant. Short-term memory, therefore, takes in the seven most relevant chunks of information at any point in time, and can last anywhere between 15 to 30 seconds. After that point, the information will be forgotten, unless it's rehearsed. This process, called the rehearsal buffer, is what keeps information active in our short-term memory before reaching a rehearsal threshold and passing through to long-term memory, a memory store with unlimited capacity, which can last anything from a few minutes to a lifetime. Here's the common diagrammatical representation of the two-process model. Incoming information passes through sensory memory, where Atkinson and Shiffrin say it is scanned and matched with information in long-term memory for pattern recognition and relevance. Relevant information is transferred to the short-term memory. Cognitive psychologists tend to roughly agree on Miller's magic number, which says we can hold 7 plus or minus 2 chunks of information in short-term memory. And after a process of rehearsal, information is transferred to long-term memory for later recall. Any information that makes it to short-term memory but is not rehearsed enough to transfer to long-term memory is simply forgotten and won't be available for later recall. Sound simple enough? Well, most of the content should be fairly familiar to you, as the concept of primary and secondary memory has been floating around since the time of William James in 1890. And a key strength of this model is that it is very clear to understand and test. However, as subsequent studies have suggested, there is much more to memory, or memories, than Atkinson and Shiffrin might have imagined. Click the subscribe button if you enjoyed this video, and if you also click the bell, YouTube will let you know when the next video is ready for you to watch, rehearse, and remember forever.